So hello friends, today we will be continuing the discussion on Mycobacterium leprae, and we have already finished I think 80% of Mycobacterium according to the concepts of microbiology in the previous two parts. Now in this topic we will be talking about ending this topic. Okay, so let us share the screen now. So giving you a review in a nutshell, if you are able to see some while you are going from your TT to LL, we said while going from TT to LL, if we see a thickened nerve, unilateral nerve, that thickened unilateral nerve can get that won't you know once you are going towards LL like this from TT to LL, from TT to LL, if in this case one nerve was involved, here multiple nerves will be involved, more nerves will be involved. If here there was unilateral involvement of nerves, here there will be bilateral involvement of nerves. If in this case I was having SSS negative, while going towards the LL I will be seeing SSS positive, isn't it? If here I had a tubercular granuloma, here there were foam cells. Are you able to understand? If here I had dry lesions, okay, here I will have shiny lesions. Because why? Why? Because sweating is improving. Because sweating is improving. See, my dears, this is a concept. Sweating is improving and compression is going. Compression is going. That's why. These are the ways you can remember concepts. If you were seeing very big lesions in TT, here you will be appreciating small lesions in TT. I told you this, I am giving a review right now. Okay, even if you have not watched those videos before your exam, can watch this part to have a rapid review. Okay, so anesthetic lesions present more in the TT, they recover in LL, isn't it? This is how I can enumerate how many points you can enumerate in your brain according to the pathophysiology, how disease is happening. So if I was appreciating in TT hypopigmented or erythematous lesions, here I will be appreciating less hypopigmentation. There was hypopigmentation, here there will be less hypopigmentation. There was erythema, here will be more erythema. Here will be more erythema. So if I was appreciating a very well demarcated lesions, well defined margins, elevated margins, here I will be having an ill-defined margin, an ill-defined lesion. If I was having a number 5 lesions here it will be 10, 15, 20. So this is all I have told you. And I told you Gren's zone. I told you yesterday Gren's zone. Formation will start becoming more prominent in lepromatous LL. Are we able to understand, guys? So there are some reactions now in the LL, leprosy, I mean. They are known as lepra reaction. But I have taught you already the concepts of lepra reaction. Here I want to enumerate some points about them. Okay. See. How I am responding, I've taught you in the first part of the video. Go and check it. First part, Mycobacterium leprae, part 1. I have taught you, if I have a type 1 reaction, can I say it is an upgrading reaction? Mm-hmm. Yes, I can say because I have taught you the concept. So type 1 lepra reaction is called upgrading. Can I call it reversal? Yes, it's called reversal also. Which lepra reaction is called erythema nodosum leprosum? Which lepra reaction is called erythema nodosum leprosum? Type 2. Lepra reaction is called erythema nodosum leprosum. Erythema nodosum leprosum. Are we able to understand? Now, what is the difference between them? type 1 and type 2. If you want, I can give a difference. I can make a chart for you. Okay, see. Okay, let us make like this. Type 1. This is all based on immunity. So see, type 1, which type of hypersensitivity reaction involved? Type 1, which type of hypersensitivity involved? Type 4 hypersensitivity reaction, that is delay type of hypersensitivity, isn't it? So it's a delayed hypersensitivity reaction. That is type 4. Type 2 Lepra reaction, we should write in Roman, okay? Sometimes in spokes it's written in Roman, or sometimes in just numerical, it's okay. So type 2 is type 3. Remember like this, type 3 is immune mediated, isn't it? There is immune complex mediated. So how to remember? Once you are in the exam hall, just do one thing. Talk to yourself, you can't write there because it's a computer based test. What you do is you make 1, 2, 3, 4. So this goes with this and this goes with this. That's it. Type 1, type 4 delayed hypersensitivity reaction, type 2, type 3 hypersensitivity. Done. No confusion. There should not be any. Don't give it even 30 seconds to tick. Don't give it even 30 seconds to tick. Even 30 seconds. Save those 30 seconds to some other question. Okay. So this is how we can remember. Even if you don't know the concept, type 1, that it goes to 4, 2 and 3 are remaining. Okay. Easy. So let us come back. Delay type of hypersensitivity is happening. Which leprosy shows type 1 reaction? Which leprosy shows type 1 reaction? Listen again, borderline, that's a beautiful answer. Borderline, I told you all the form BT, BB, BL and severe most in the BL. Once moving, yeah, very nice. Once we are moving towards LL, that's what I want. That's the borderline, I can see. So spectrum of borderline, you should remember borderline spectrum. If they ask you, I told you, if they ask you this question, you have to say BT, BB, BL. BT, BB, BL. Okay. And where will you be appreciating more? No, a nice, not nice, actually, more prominent, I can say, type 1 reaction. That is BL. BL will be the prominent. Okay. Okay, guys. It's okay. Okay, which type of type 2? Which will be showing type 2? Type 2 will be shown by which? Type 2, that is B cell mediated, I have taught you. Yes? Yeah, so we will write LL and BL. Now, if there is a question, please listen to me. Please listen to me. If they ask you in the option, they have put what? I will tell you. If they put both LL and BL, LL and BL, and they have put TT, and they have put BT, these two are wrong. Now you are stuck in these two, and the question is asking choose the best option. This should be the answer. What? This should be the answer. Tick LL. Okay, this is also done. Second question, it will be what things you are appreciating in type 1 reaction. Okay, I will write some word. What things you are appreciating? So put a question on this. I think it has been asked a long time back. Inflammation of existing lesions. inflammation of existing lesions. What do you mean by that? There will be, if inflammation is happening, then signs of inflammation should come. Redness, pain, edema of that lesion. Isn't it? These skin lesions will get inflamed. Or if I talk about the nerve involvement will be neuritis. Neuritis. But if, remember, there's a concept. If I have, for example, in case of, let me take a borderline BT. What happens in BT? I'm going towards medicine. What happens in BT is, if suddenly a nerve is getting involved, if suddenly sudden neuritis happens, will lead to a permanent nerve damage and will lead to a nerve abscess formation. Will lead to a nerve abscess. So remember, if I have a permanent nerve involvement, what will happen at a sudden? I mean sudden. First I have to write sudden. Sudden will cause permanent nerve damage. That will lead to nerve abscess. Okay guys, this you have to remember. And in type 1 reaction, you won't be appreciating. See, I told you there is redness, pain. But I'm going to tell you that there is no fever. There is no fever. Type 1 reaction, no fever. Are we able to understand? But if I go into type 2 reaction, I will be appreciating what? Since it is a humoral immunity. Since it is a humoral immunity. And is a type 3 hypersensitivity reaction. So what will happen is that this immune complex will get deposited. It's moving in the blood. This immune complex, you remember, isn't it? An antigen and an antibody. So your antibody is reacting to this antigen. So they are moving. They have hugged together and they are now moving in the blood vessels. So what will happen? They will get deposited at some place. That will lead to vasculitis. That is called, very nicely in medicine books written, leukocytoclastic vasculitis. It's involved by TNF-alpha. Okay, so let me write, because I have integrated everything here. Leukocytoclastic vasculitis. Leukocytoclastic vasculitis. So what is the concept of leukocytoclastic vasculitis? Leukocytoclastic vasculitis means when a type 3 hypersensitivity reaction, that is immune complex reaction, is happening, and that immune complex is getting deposited at some place in a blood vessel, will lead to consequences of fibrinous. I don't have to talk that because you are first year people. So there will be a sort of a vessel reaction. There will be, in short, for first year people, I will say a vessel will be inflamed. Okay, a vessel will get started inflaming, and that we call a leukocytoclastic vasculitis. And the cytokine is TNF-alpha. TNF-alpha is the cytokine. Okay, now what you will be appreciating here, I told you that you have an inflammation of old lesions, you have red pain, edema, you have neuritis, you have sudden neuritis, will lead to permanent damage, will lead to nerve abscess formation, mostly seen in BT. What you will be appreciating in that type 2 reaction, that is ENL. ENL means type 2 ENL means, yeah, please write someone. Type 2 ENL means erythema nodosum leprosum. Erythema nodosum leprosum, that means erythema, listen to me, that means erythema nodosum leprosum. That means erythema means red, then I should write red. Nodosum means nodes, that means I should say nodules. That means erythema is there, so it should be pain also, so it should be tender. It should be tender. Old or new? Here what was happening? Old lesions were getting, in type 1, old lesions were getting inflammation. But here old lesions are not, there are new lesions. And whatever old lesions you have in type 2 reaction, they will not change their shape. They will be as they were. So you will be appreciating tender, red, papules or nodules. So two things you have to remember. Papules, nodules in type 2 reaction. Where will you be appreciating, sir? Go to face. Go to your extremities. Okay, limbs. Okay guys, so sir, you told that type 1 reaction is not having fever. Is type 2 reaction having fever? Yes, sir. Has all signs of inflammation. Has all signs of inflammation. Arthralgia is there. Conjunctivitis is there. Keratitis is there. Nephritis is there. Synovitis is there. Orchitis is there. Hepatosplenomegaly is there. Iritis is there. Generalized lymphadenopathy is there. All these is there. Let me write something for you. So in systemic inflammation, there is arthralgia. There is fever. There is hepatosplenomegaly, hepatosplenomegaly. There is nephritis. There is keratitis. There is orchitis. That is, testes are involved. There is generalized lymphadenopathy. Generalized lymphadenopathy. How we will understand, guys? Okay. Okay. So see, guys, more you will be learning in your dermatology. Okay. I want to go towards one thing. Another thing I want to write is here. You are seeing as you were progressing. Again, I'm repeating the same thing in the past two videos I have taught you. Once you are proceeding towards LL, that is downgrading reaction. I told you, once you are going from TT to LL, downgrading reaction is happening. And once you are going from LL to TT by use of treatment, reversal reaction. So this is all happening in the type 1. But I told you type 2 begins when you start a chemotherapy, that's giving a treatment. Once you are giving chemotherapy, because it's an immune complex mediated, so there will be antigen-antibody reaction. Okay. So now you tell me one thing. Where should I write TH1? Should I write it type 1 or type 2? Even a small child, small LKG boy will tell. So TH1 will be in type 1, TH2 will be in type 2. That is T helper cell. Which type of T helper cell will be there? Okay. So going to the treatment part, I think we haven't gone through the diagnostic test, isn't it? We have directly moved towards this. So I will be telling you that's a small thing. Okay. Let us tell you in the end. Okay. Lab diagnosis. Or let me tell you first the lab diagnosis. Actually, the way is to first tell you the diagnosis. See, first I give you a microbiological way, what we are seeing in microbiology. We do a smear. Let us go to lab diagnosis. In lab diagnosis, we will do first a smear microscopy. In smear microscopy, you have to search for AFP, that is acid fast bacilli. He is itself an acid fast bacilli. Okay. What do you do is, for example, this is the body of the patient. Okay. This is the body of the patient. And I think it's more like a teddy bear. So what you will do is you have to take in total 6 samples. You have to take 6 samples. 6 samples out of 6, 4 samples should be, 4 should be from the skin. 4 should be from the skin. That is, you have to go for forehead. Let me make a star. So take from forehead, take from cheeks, chin, and buttocks. Okay. I don't know how to show the buttocks. Okay. So from the buttocks. Okay. And you can take air lobe and nasal mucosa. Okay. These are the sites you have to take the sample. And for example, this was the edge last time. So what place you will check for the region, which sample, where to take, sir, from the sample? Is it from the edge or from the flat center? Take the better is to take it from the edge. You have to take it from the edge. Then what technique will you use? SSS, isn't it? What is SSS? Thinking good things, slit skin smear, slit skin smear, isn't it? And then on the basis of that smear, we used to classify them on the basis of TT and LL. Okay. Sir, how to take the nose nasal specimens? You can take by nasal scraping or nasal blow. Okay, nasal blow. So you can take these. Now, sir, what about nerves? Do we take any samples from the nerves? Yeah, we take biopsies. Okay, but it's not like we will not be taking that biopsy of the nerve like that. But yeah, in some cases, it's the severity is so much that we will be taking the biopsy of the nerves. Okay. Now, what you will be doing? Which staining will you do for this bacilli? Very nice answer. Very nice answer. Sharia Saad. So, Z. Nielsen staining. What you will do? Can you tell me the name of the chemical used in this? Which chemical you will be using, guys? Beautiful answer. That's a 5% sulfuric acid is used. Okay? 5% sulfuric acid is used. Some people are writing chemical formulas. Very nice answer. Okay? So, let me tell you first. One thing, what you will be appreciating in the microscopy is you will be seeing some red color. I have taught you in the mycobacterium tuberculosis that you will be having it. Red acid fast bacilli. You know, sometimes they may be together, sometimes they may be present as single. Okay, so that you will be appreciating. So let me tell you first thing is this SSS. Let me give you something about this SSS. Yeah, very nice. So, what you will be seeing, WHO, World Health Organization, has told, it has recommended that if a country is having, if there is an endemic country, in an endemic country, a person can be told or a person can be, diagnosed, I can say, or regarded as having leprosy if he is showing us one or more than these signs. If a person in an endemic area is showing, I will be telling you three signs, then he should be considered as a person of leprosy. First point. Hypopigmented, but the country should endemic country. Okay, endemic country, hypopigmented or reddish erythematous skin, and plus that place is showing us a sensory loss. So I can say it's a definite sensory loss. Second point is if nerves are thickened. Third point, skin smear tests are positive. Okay, guys. So can I make it? Can I do like this? Can I tell you a mnemonic? How to remember? How I remember about leprosy? These are called cardinal signs. These are called cardinal signs. See how I remember it. See, look at me. Just look at me. LEPROSY. Okay. So L stands for loss of sensation. This is the way I remember. E stands for enlarged nerves. P stands for positive AFP. Guys, I have told you so many times. Please, you should not turn on your microphones. I don't know where did we lost the connection. Then the recording won't be available. for doing these things, guys. Yeah, so where did we got disconnected, guys? Yeah, what I have to repeat? LEP, okay. Before that, have you understood? Loss of sensation, enlarged nerves, and positive AFP. Okay, now this is how I remember about cardinal signs of leprosy. Cardinal signs of leprosy. Okay, so let me tell you something about SSS, skin slit smear test. Slit skin smear. Simply, I will tell you what we are doing in skin slit smear. What we do is, slit means I have to make small slits. So what I do is I take a blade. Wow, what a blade. Okay, I take a blade. And then in this blade, what I do is, I make slits. Okay. And now I stain them. You know, I told you, they are saying, WHO is telling us that 4 sites should be taken. But you can take at least 3 sites. Okay. So 4 sites should be from the skin. Okay. Now what will happen is, once you stain them, okay, you have taken the sample and now we are staining them. What will you do is, you put them under AFB staining. Once you put them under AFB staining, you will be seeing patterns. There will be some patterns. You will be seeing some patterns. The staining patterns will be variable. Like some will be showing what? S pattern. Some will be showing F pattern. Some will be showing G pattern. Okay. So what is this, sir? SFG. S means solid. Solid. Some will be fragmented. And some bacilli will be showing granular appearance. Okay, remember this concept. So how to get the do you now tell me one thing. Okay, let us do like this. Out of SFG, how many are living? How many bacilli are living? Out of SFG, how many bacilli are living? Which bacilli is living? Which bacilli is living? No, solid is living. Solid is a viable organism. It's a viable. These are all dead. These are dead bacilli. These are dead bacilli. So can anyone count, get me the bacterial index? Who can calculate the bacterial index for me? Who can calculate bacterial index? I have taught you in the general microbiology. Who can calculate for me? The bacterial index will be is equal to S plus F plus G. We are taking everything, living plus dead. I taught you bacterial index. And you will be appreciating this, what you will see is bacterial index will still be positive, even if you are giving the therapy. Okay. Now, what about morphological index? Morphological index, we only take S. S means living. We only take S. Remember, bacterial index, we always say, we have a scale for this, that is 0 to 6. But for morphological index, we have percentages. We say, like if someone tells you morphological index is 50%, so that means 50% are alive, 50% are living. Now tell me, should the patient have a decreased, should as you are a doctor, okay, so that means as a doctor when I am treating a case of leprosy, should the morphological index decrease or increase? Morphological index should decrease, because sir, morphological index means the percentage of the bacilli under the microscope which are alive, which are solid, isn't it? So if they are living, then living should die more. That means if you are killing more bacilli, that means index should decrease. Because when I am saying there is 60% MI, 60% MI, it means 60% are alive. Now after giving treatment, I have intervened, I have given Dapsone or something, it reached to 20%. Is it a good news or bad news for me? Is it a good news? Yes, it's a good news, because her morphological index is living has decreased. That means your treatment is good, your drug resistance is, you know, even yeah, it can tell you resistance also. If it that means if you are even giving the drug and morphological index is not decreasing, or there is no significant decrease in the morphological index, meaning thereby I should understand either the drug resistance is there, because if you are treating, then definitely it will be drug resistance. So that means he is not responding to therapy. That means drug resistance is there. Okay. So if it's decreasing, that means the treatment is efficacious. You are giving the treatment, efficacy is beautiful. Okay. So this is the concept. More you will be learning about this in, you know, medicine, surgery, medicine and dermatology. Okay. So here I have just given you a from the point of view of microbiology. See, once you're putting it under the microscope, you know, sometimes you see appearance, they call it as, you know, what they do is the bacilli is having a lipid-like substance. It is having a lipid-like substance that is called glia. Now, glia will form, if you see something in groups, they will give you a cigarette bundle appearance. Cigarette bundle appearance, okay? I don't know how to draw a cigarette, but yeah, something. Okay, cigarette bundle appearance, not to make flagella or something. You can think like this. No, don't think like that. Glia, let me make glia. Glia is attaching them. Glia is attaching them to form dash. This all is called globi. So glia will attach them to form globi. If you see a cigarette bundle appearance, not cigarette, you should write cigar, because I have drawn it very much long. Cigar bundle appearance is due to dash. Cigar bundle appearance is due to dash. Or globi is due to dash. Due to dash, guys. Guys, what is the answer? Beautiful answer. So glia. Okay. Glia means glue. Something like that, remember. So once you attach things together, the combination, you are getting a cigar bundle appearance or globi. And who is doing that? Glia. Who is doing that? Glia. Okay. Now these globi, where will you see them? You will see them in the foamy macrophages. I have told you. So tell me, where is more foamy macrophages? Is it in the, is it in the B, T more or LL? Beautiful answer. Beautiful answer. So what three names I had given you in the first video? What three names I had given you for the first video? For the three names of foamy macrophages, I told you these are called varicose cells. Varicose cells. Another name was lepra cells. Another name was foamy cells. Isn't it? Three names of what? Three names of these globi. Macrophages. These foamy macrophages. So you either call it foamy cells, lepra cells, varicose cells. Okay, So if I tell you I am appreciating fragmented and granular things, I should say dash bacilli. If I am telling you I am seeing fragmented or granular appearance, I should say dash bacilli, dead bacilli. If I am seeing solid ends, length is, you know, 5 times greater than the width. Length is 5 times greater than the width. What should I say? Dash bacilli. Very nice. Okay. I think you have understood this. Okay. So let me tell you, what is the best site to get the sample if the case has been treated? Treated cases, what is the best site for SSS, slits, smear? The best site is dorsum of fingers. Okay, dorsum of fingers. I will understand. Second question you should write, SSS, what is the lower limit for detecting the bacilli? How much bacilli should be present in 1 gram of tissue? How much bacilli? It should be greater than 10,000. Greater than 10,000 in 1 gram of tissue, then only your slit, skin, smear will be positive. So can I say SSS is negative in TT? SSS is negative in TT. Beautiful answer. I hope you remember what is the meaning of this. SSS is negative in TT. Can I say SSS is negative in indeterminate Hansen's? I hope you are understanding what I mean, what my language means. Very nice. Can I say pure neural Hansen? Pure neural Hansen has negative SSS. Pure neural Hansen. Very nice. And it is this pure neural Hansen. I told you what is pure neural Hansen. When you are having what? What you are having, what is the concept of pure neural Hansen? Yes, who can tell me? What is the concept of pure neural Hansen? Pure neural Hansen meant dash. Peripheral nerve loss or sensation? Only nerve involved and sensation? What about sensation? Okay. Yeah. So this is the concept behind this. Okay. So in pure neural leprosy, pure neural Hansen's, you will be taking a nerve biopsy. Simple. You will be taking a nerve biopsy, isn't it? Yeah. You will be taking nerve biopsy. Okay. So who will confirm diagnosis for you? Skin biopsy. But in pure neural, nerve biopsy will tell you. And that we do, that's called FNAC. FNAC is finite laceration cytology. I'll be learning more about it in surgery. So, which is a prognostic test, by the way? Which is a prognostic test? Lepromine test is a prognostic test. Lepromine test is a prognostic test. Okay, and it was on the basis of this lepromine test that we are classifying leprosy into negative lepromine, positive lepromine, tuberculite, lepromatous. Okay. So you can't use lepromine test for diagnosis because it will come positive in me also, normal people. Okay. And we had, not to go in that, we had two responses that was called Fernand's response and Mitsuda response, 48 hours, 4 weeks. Don't need to go into that. But remember, for nerves, neural, we go for pure neural leprosy, we go FNAC. FNAC, we aspirate some, we take a needle and we aspirate some cells which are present around it. I think we have finished. I want to tell you two things more. I want to tell you first some principles of lepromine test. Like I had told you about this tuberculin test. So first, let me, before going into that, I will tell you, did I told you in the last video about mouse foot? I told you that we inoculate the foot for cultivating. Do we know that point? Yeah, we know that point. Okay. So, sir, is there any way to detect antibody? Yeah, there is a way. We can use FLA-ABS. We can use FLA-ABS. We can use ELISA. We can use FLA-ABS. We can use ELISA. FLA-ABS is fluorescent leprosy antibody absorption test. Fluorescent leprosy antibody absorption test. ELISA is enzymatic immunosorbent assay. So what we do in ELISA is you are taking the IgM antibodies to dash glycolipid. What was the name of glycolipid? PGL1. What is PGL1? Phenolic glycolipid 1. Okay, this is an antigen which is present on the Mycobacterium leprae. So let me tell you something about leprosomin test. Leprosomin test is telling me about dash type of hypersensitivity, delay type of hypersensitivity reaction, and whether the person is having a nice cell mediated immunity or not, isn't it? So what is it telling me? It is telling me whether the person is having a nice cell mediated immunity or not. What you do is, we take 0.1 ml of leprosomin antigen, and we intradermally put it. I have told you last time, intradermally on the what? Flexor side of forearm. Okay. And we take two readings. Two readings are taken. One reading is taken at 48 hours. Another reading is taken at 21 days. Okay. Now, early reading will tell me, let us discuss that. Early reading will tell me, early reading is also known as, this is early reading. Early reading will show a response that is called Fernand's response. Fernand's response means there will be, if there is induration plus erythema greater than 10 mm, if this is coming in the early 48 hours, we say this person is having delayed hypersensitivity reaction, and that means the person has been exposed to lepra bacilli in the past. I'm repeating again, Fernand's reaction is telling me that the person is having delayed hypersensitivity reaction right now, and he has been previously in the past exposed to lepra bacilli. But remember, red pen, it does not tell you about active infection. Do we remember the tuberculin test also, Montox? Same like that. It's not telling you about the active, not infection. Okay, active infection. What is late reading now? Late reading, 21 days or at 4 weeks, you can remember, it's called late reading or Mitsuda reaction. In Mitsuda reaction, if you see nodule, I have taught you in the past in skin histology, differences between nodule, papule, maculopapule, you can go to that section to remember. Okay, nodule greater than 5 mm at the place where you have put this leprosomin, and that leads to ulceration, finally goes to ulceration in later stages. It says the patient is having cell mediated immunity, which is intact, very nice cell mediated immunity. Okay, so simple short questions for you. Simple short question, just give me the answer. True or false? Just tell me whether I'm true or false. Fernand's reaction tells me about active infection. False. Very nice answer. It does not tell me about ओके, मिट्सुडा रिएक्शन टेल्स मी अबाउट सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी इंटैक्टनेस. वेरी नाइस आंसर, इट्स ट्रू. एट व्हाट टाइम मिट्सुडा रिएक्शन सीन, मिट्सुडा रिएक्शन एट व्हाट टाइम. वेरी नाइस, फर्नांड्स रिएक्शन एट व्हाट टाइम, फर्नांड्स रिएक्शन. ओके, वेरी नाइस, वेरी ब्यूटिफुल आंसर. ओके, सो लेट अस टेल यू वेयर एम आई यूजिंग दिस लेप्रामिन टेस्ट यूजेस. ओके, यूजेस नंबर वन, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ लेप्रसी. सेकेंड, प्रोग्नोसिस. आई टोल्ड यू कैन इट कांट बी यूज फॉर डायग्नोसिस. रेजिस्टेंट लेप्रसी. Okay. By the way, the people who are negative lepramin are at a high risk of getting multibacillary leprosy. Multibacillary leprosy. The people who are having a negative lepramin will be having a higher risk of getting multibacillary leprosy. Can we understand the concept behind this word? Okay. Should we go to the treatment part now? Should we go to the treatment part? I want to enumerate the treatment in detail. Okay. See. Just go to the. Okay. So. What WHO has recommended us, WHO has recommended that if we have to apply what multi-drug therapy. We have to go for multi-drug therapy. Okay. But before treating in dermatology, what we do is we have to establish the fact. We have to establish whether they are having nerve damage, whether there is any sort of hypoesthesia, whether there is any sort of a color discoloration. And it has been seen, we have to know if some wrong is done. So what we do is, we go for in the treatment part, we are mostly oriented towards nerve thickenings, we are oriented towards patches, we are oriented towards plaques, we are oriented towards SSS. So these things you have to keep in mind. Okay. If you tell me, sir, which is the strong bactericidal drug and a very important anti-leprosy drug, it is rifampicin. Rifampicin. Okay. Okay. So, what about Dapsone, sir? Dapsone are not so much strong. They are very weak bactericidal. Okay. So, maybe, rifampicin, according to my knowledge, it kills all the viable S. bacilli, within 4 days. For example, today you give a single dose, 4 days after the bacteria will die. Okay. That's so much strong. So now WHO has told us, according to the age group, okay, it has told us that adult, children, and adult children, that means 10 to 14 years, and children less than 10 or less than 40 kg. Okay. Less than 40 kg. So adult. In adult, you will start RCD. What is RCD? Rifampicin. Clofazimine. And Dapsone. What is the dosage? 600 mg. once a month. Clofazimine 300 mg once a month and 50 mg daily. Okay, Dapsone 100 mg daily. This is what you have to give for adult. Okay, for multibacillary, in this case, 12 months. For posibacillary, 6 months. Okay, are you able to understand the duration? Multibacillary, this. Posibacillary, this much. Okay, can you understand? Guys, is it clear? So up to 6 months, the therapy for an adult posibacillary load will be 6 months. That's why I'm writing in this way so that you can learn. Okay. So in children, I will again RCD, rifampicin, clofazimine, Dapsone. How much dosage, sir? 450 mg. Once a month. This is a WHO guideline. Okay. 450 mg once a month. Clofazimine was 150 mg once a month, 50 mg daily. And D, Dapsone 50 mg daily. So that's why I'm telling you, this is children, this is adult. So we have half the dose, half the dose. So for multibacillary in children, 12 months. For posibacillary, 6 months. If you can't remember, you have to do like this. See, multibacillary 12-6, 12-6, here also 12-6. Okay, now easy. Multibacillary, posibacillary. Why I'm writing multi first? Because M and OP. P comes after M. P comes after M. So I remember M, then write 12. P, write 6. What comes first is not first. It comes here. What comes second is not first. Is not second, comes first. Children less than 10 or less than 40 RCD again. Now here it is 450. Now here it will be 10 mg per kg. Because in children we go for weight. According to weight we give the drug once a month. C for clofazimine, I have written already. 6 mg per kg once a month. And 1 mg per kg daily. Okay, that is same for multibacillary, posibacillary, same. Okay, 12, 12, 12, 6, 6, 6. D for Dapsone, 2 mg per kg daily. This is the treatment plan. Is it tough? What you do is, first you go for RCD. This is adult, sir. This is children, sir, age 10 to 14 years. This is how we practice at home. And this is 10 children. And then less than 40. So what I learn is 600, 300, 100. This 450, according to that, I am decreasing 150 and 50. 10, 6, 2. Are we able to understand? Is it clear? So 12, 6, 12, 6, 12, 6. This is okay. Hardly will take 10 to 15 minutes at home to practice. That's it. Okay, I say always to my students and to myself also, if you want to see mathematics of medicine, mathematics, I feel it's pharmacology, no learning, no numberings and everything. Love that. Yeah. Now, one concept students are not told. By the way, you will be reading about these drugs in pharmacology because this is a microbiology. We have taken a long session for microbiology. So, rifampicin, these will be learning. What is the side effect of Dapsone? It can cause anemia. It can cause Dapsone hypersensitivity syndrome. That is also called fifth week syndrome. Characterized by erythroderma, fever, lymphadenopathy, hepatitis. And rifampicin, it is a nice bactericidal drug. It is a cornerstone of leprosy management, I can say, isn't it? So remember one word, rifampicin is a cornerstone. Cornerstone of leprosy management. Okay. clofazimine is there. Its side effect you have to learn in pharmacology. It can cause ichthyosis, thickenings. It can cause darkening of skin. It can cause discoloration. Ethionamide, prothionamide. You have to learn fluoroquinolones, moxifloxacin, okay? Minocycline, clarithromycin. These are all the drugs which you can use in leprosy. Wait of 9 to 10 years old child. 9 to 10 years old child, give this. 9 to 10 years old child, give this. Okay. Don't start becoming mathematicians. Directly go for the age. Okay. If age is not there, then I go for age of weight. Okay. It's so simple. Okay. So, I want to tell you something about leprosy packet, which is not taught to you. This is a leprosy packet. And we are ending the session, okay? So this is guys' leprosy packet. What you see is, what the patient is, how he is remembering his dosage is this all, okay? Okay, black is a nice color. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is one, this. So you have to give it once a month. What is present in these capsules? Once a month. Okay. So it's about, you know, day one, day two, day three. Okay. So day one, you have to give day one, two capsules of rifampicin. These are rifampicin. Two capsules of rifampicin. That is 300 mg twice, isn't it? 300 mg twice. Okay. Three capsules of clofazimine. Three capsules of clofazimine, 100 mg for, and there is a tablet of Dapsone. There is a tablet of Dapsone, which is 100 mg. There is a tablet of Dapsone, which is 100 mg. Okay. What about these two, sir? How will be taking this? This is once a day. This was once a month. This is once a day. Once a day, that is day 2 to day 28. Day 2 to day 28. One capsule of clofazimine. One capsule of clofazimine. Okay. Okay, guys. And one tablet of Dapsone. One tablet of Dapsone. Dapsone is white, okay? 100 mg. This is clofazimine, how much? 50 mg. Is it clear? So at least remember, if you aren't even not able to remember this, at least at this point, first year, just remember leprosy packet is something. Okay. Okay, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this session. I'll be making more videos on this. If you have any doubts, questions, queries, can contact me. Okay. I can't put my email here because so many mails coming every day. Don't even check. So we'll be giving you a small email ID soon, okay, so that you can contact me. Thank you very much. GBU, that's God bless you. And see you all tomorrow with a new topic. Work hard. Enjoy medicine. Live like a legend.